Welcome to part three of how to use artificial intelligence to make a simulation model of just about anything. If you missed parts one and two, they're available on our YouTube channel, Keysight ESOF. So far, I've shown you how to make an artificial neural network model of an amplifier's nonlinear gain and phase responses. In this video, we're going to turn those responses into voltages and currents that can be run through the circuit simulator. Here's where we left off in part two. I've got a DC simulation and these long ANN equations for gain and phase. These equations take an input, which is a variable, and they provide an output, which is also a variable. But we want electrical signals. Well, it's fairly easy to do that in ADS. For example, to make the voltage equal to the ANN input, just set the supply value to the X variable. Remember, that clamps P in, which drives the ANN equations. The result is a voltage on the resistor that tracks the ANN input. On the other hand, I could set the voltage on this supply equal to the ANN output, which is gain, and run a simulation. Now I have a voltage across this resistor which corresponds to gain. But the driver here is a variable, X, rather than a voltage. So it seems like we can do either one side of the ANN equation or the other as an electrical signal, but not yet both. The thing is, we're trying to model an amplifier here, so we really need both the input and output to be electrical signals. And it turns out that's possible to do in ADS using equation-based models. There are two types, linear and nonlinear, and since the amplifier's response here is clearly nonlinear, that is, the output doesn't scale linearly with input, equation-based nonlinear models are the ones to use. There are two types of nonlinear models, symbolically defined devices and frequency domain defined devices. Both are potentially applicable here, however, because this is an RF amplifier, we're ultimately going to analyze it in the frequency domain. So I think it makes more sense to use an FDD for this particular example. I've got a schematic with an FDD, two-port FDD, and a harmonic balance controller. And in the FDD, there are options to set up an equation. The output can be current, voltage, or other stuff, and there are two index terms, the port number and the harmonic. Now, the trick with these components is it's possible to sense the electrical signal at any port and make it part of a function. That's the trick to having control over both input and output. So for example, the equation for sensed voltage at port 1 harmonic 1 is underscore SV11. To emulate a 50 ohm resistor, all we have to do is set I11 equal to underscore SV11 divided by 50 because I equals V over R. And let's make a new term for port 2. We'll set the voltage at port 2 to twice the voltage at port 1. And I'll run a harmonic balance simulation there and plot the magnitude of the input current. And you can see there's a 20 milliamp tone as expected, and we can also plot the output voltage, and you can see that's 6 dB because 20 log 2 is 6. Now, if you think about the amplifier, input power comes in, output power goes out, and the phase gets shifted along the way. These two response curves really capture all of that. But to get this information into the FDD, we need voltages. That's not too difficult, it's just a little bit of engineering math. Here it is if you're interested, but regardless, we've got to rework the ANN model so that both the input and output are voltages. And it would be convenient if the phase here was also in radians. Well, I applied these formulas in my original Excel spreadsheet and I transformed the input to a voltage. Then I computed output as input times gain, and lastly, I converted the phase to radians. So let's train an ANN model on this data. I'll just copy and paste it into a new text file, and then I'll go to my training script and run the ANN model training. Now, in the output equations, let's replace the underscore V1 with underscore VN, but we'll do the inputs a little differently this time. For the top one, I'm going to make that Vout parentheses underscore VN. So in other words, Vout's a function of VN. And similarly for phase, I'll call that phrad parentheses underscore vn. Let's copy and paste those into the ADS schematic just like before. I'll place a new variable there, and then I'm going to paste the first one. Then I go back, grab the second one, go back to ADS and paste that in. Okay. So next I need to change this voltage source to a P1 tone, and then I'll need a Pin variable. So we'll sweep P in the harmonic balance controller from minus 15 to 5, and I also have to rework the FDD model a little bit. The input port is just 50 ohms, that stays the same, but the output's going to reference the ANN variable equations, and we can pass the input voltage directly into those equations. So V21 will equal Vout as a function of underscore SV11 times exponent j times the phase as a function of underscore SV11. In other words, this senses Vin, computes Vout and phase from the A and N equations based on this Vin, and then it sets the output voltage at port 2 accordingly. All that's left to do is run the simulation, and I've got the output curves computed from the harmonic balance results. These are now real signals. We can look at the output sweep, for example, in the time domain here. You can see these curves all match the curves that we started with. This is a full model of the nonlinear amplifier from that original picture. And when we started out, this was just a picture. Now it's a real model. You can use this for all kind of analysis. You can maybe run a modulated signal through it or look at how it performs in your system. I hope you found this set of tutorials useful. I'll make the workspace available for download on our YouTube channel, Keysight ESOF. Thanks for watching. See you next time.